claim relative ignorance of this miracle until this morning when I first made aware of it. But I guess from my perspective, as I understand it, this happened in the 8th century. And it's the blood and the tissue have been tested, and the blood has the same blood type, if you will, the blood in the shroud. One of the amazing things for me is how this blood is incredibly, it's used in a microbiology lab to grow bacteria. How this tissue, this blood clot can be there for 1,200 plus years and not be overgrown with fungus and anything else that you would, you know, scrape off the barn, you know, your barn floor. I'm amazed. And as I understand too, there were no preservatives or salts detected in the muscle tissue. And on granted, this is 40 years ago, we're a little more sophisticated now, but with the basic stains that they use, it's clearly cardiac muscle that's 1,200 years old and not rotted away. That to me is, it's miraculous.
Yeah.
My name is Mario, for those of you who don't know me. I was asked a few questions by some of the people on the bus that we drove in on. DNA, well, red blood cells are pretty much devoid of DNA, so there wasn't a whole lot there, and it degrades pretty quickly. When they looked at the muscle, it is not just a few cells of muscle tissue, it is an intact unit of muscular tissue. There is a portion of the vagus nerve, which is one of the main nerves that controls the function of the heart. There is the myocardium and the epicardium, two different sections and types of muscle within the heart. The cells are all oriented and properly to each other, and there's even what we call ramifications, the muscle branches and like roads. And there's absolutely no evidence that the tissue has been cut. You could not, with modern 21st century technology, take a piece of a heart, cut it out, and make it look like what that looked like under the microscope. It can't happen today. Now, of course, we've got all things are possible, but based on our human technology, that's not happening. An interesting thing that Stacy brought up on our bus is that the AB blood type is considered the universal recipient. That means you can take anybody's blood and it won't interact with your system. So, not to stretch it too far, but Jesus can take any of us and accept us into his body, and there's no rejection, there's no reaction. You take a different type of blood type, you can't receive it. If you're O, you can't receive anything but O. So this type of blood can receive everyone into it, and that type extends even into the muscle tissue that's there. One other thing that I found, I was doing some research on this on the way up here today, is that as miraculous as that was 1,200 years ago, it happened a week ago in Africa. It was caught on tape. It was a mass that was televised. It might not be a full week ago, but most of us probably didn't hear about it because we're not watching the news. It was a Nigerian priest in a local parish saying mass, and it happened again today, right here. And 100,000 churches around the world. I know Father said this, I know the deacon said this, but I want you to hear this from a layman. That miracle just happened.